Hi everyone, this is Ascended Twin 144K. I'm here to do a general collective read for fire signs. Excuse me. And this is something different. I want to do, why did they fuck you over? So we're going to try something different. Thank you to all of my subscribers who have subscribed to me. Much love, many blessings. Thank you for rocking with me. I love the fuck out of y'all. Also, for those of you who, you know, just come through and check me out and see what the fuck is up, love you too. Appreciate the love. Whether you subscribe or you don't. Also, y'all know I cuss. I talk hella shit in my videos. So if that's offensive to you, click the fuck off. I'm not the reader for you. Also, anything you want to know about my channel and myself will be listed in the description box below the video. As we know, time is fluid, so this could be past, present, or future energies. Take what resonates, what doesn't, fuck it. Also, check your sun, moon, rising, Mercury and Venus, north node and south node. Check your nodes, because sometimes your nodes resonate with you. That's why I run this all the way through. Also, the energies can be reversed. God damn, Mercury. Retrograde, but sometimes the energies can be reversed. This could be you or your person, and this also goes for same-sex relationships. So I asked, why did they fuck you over, fire signs? And it was because somebody offered them love, a new start in love. This could have been somebody that they were already married to or had children with. I see two children here. So this person thought that they were getting a whole fucking package with this motherfucker. And the Two of Cups, the Ten of Cups here, that's Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy. So y'all could have been dealing with some water signs. But the Angel of Temperance is here as well, Sagittarius energy. So some of y'all could have this in your chart, or your person could, or you both could. But there needed to be balance in this situation. Someone was using their intuition. Somebody put a lid on their emotions. This could be the water sign or yourself, because there was no action being taken, because I have the Queen of Cups here, more Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy. So y'all definitely could have been dealing with water signs. And we have the Four of Swords at the bottom of the deck. And this is Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. So nobody was taking action, or the person that you wanted to take action didn't take any action in this shit. They took a fucking break, or either you did. So let's go ahead. I'm going to use the Prisma Visions tarot deck to do the reading for this. So why did they fuck the fire signs over? What is the messages and what is the energies for my fire signs? We have the Eight of Wands. Somebody wants to come in swiftly with some communication. Somebody wants to reach out to you, or either you reach out to them, because there's a new opportunity to have love here. There's a new opportunity to have this happy ten of cups situation, but it has to be balanced. So this is Aries, Leo, Sagittarius for the Eight of Wands. Why did they fuck my fire signs over, please? What is the messages and what is the energies? This is, like I said, something new that I'm trying out. We're going to see what pops up. We have the Four of Chalices, Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy. So somebody wasn't accepting nor rejecting the offer. They just let the motherfucker dangle there like a goddamn deer in headlights. And I feel like this is your person that, you know, dangled your offer of wanting to be together. They didn't do anything. They took no fucking action. They acted like the Four of fucking Swords. Why did this person fuck over my fire signs? What is the messages? What is their energies, please? We have the Four of Wands. So again, it could have been because they were in a long-term, stable, committed relationship or a marriage. Some of you guys possibly could be getting an offer of marriage from this person, Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy. This is also my 1111 card, so some of you could definitely be in a twin flame situation. We have the Knight of Wands, but this person is very flighty. This motherfucker couldn't stay still if you paid him to. They're in and out. They need to take action in a situation to bring balance to this. That's why there was no balance here, because this person was in and out. They were a hoe, a gigolo, jigahoe, whatever the fuck you want to call them. And this could be, we have the Six of Chalices, so we have more Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy here. So this could definitely be a soulmate, someone from your past, someone that you are familiar with. This could be someone as far as your recent past, all the way down to a past life soulmate. And I feel like this person is now reminiscing over the time that they spent with you, fire signs. The next card that came out was Justice. So some of you could have been dealing with a Libra or have Libra in your chart. But I got a lot of fucking water out here, yo. A lot of fucking water and fire. So you definitely could have been dealing with somebody that could have been going through a legal situation. This is why they couldn't make a decision. This person could have had to go to the legal system to get justice. Maybe they got into an altercation where someone wounded them or injured them. And I'm feeling like this would have been their person. Their person was a fucking snake and they bit the shit out of them. So that was their karmic justice on that. The Three of Pentacles came up. So this person wants to come together with you, but under the Four of Wands, this could also be that they wanted to keep you in a third party situation as well. Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. So you could have been dealing with an earth sign that could have wanted to keep you in a third party. Like, I want my cake and eat it too. That type of bullshit. And you just went down with that shit. Fire signs. You was like, nigga, you lost your motherfucking cracker. Cheese done slipped the fuck completely off that goddamn cracker. If you think I'm going for a third party situation. Motherfucker, I'm not having it. And down at the bottom of the deck, check this shit out. We got the Ten of Pentacles. So this person is already in a committed relationship. They can't give you what it is that they promised you, because this motherfucker was never going to give you that in the first place. They couldn't give it to you at that particular time because they're already involved in the situation. This person has at least one child, or they're dealing with somebody that has at least one child. They don't have to be married, but they've been in a long-term committed relationship. And I want to say anywhere from 4 years on up. And I got three fours on my deck, on my board. So four fours, that's a three fours, that's a message. So some of you need to check this out. You might be seeing 444. Why did they fuck over my fire signs? What is the messages and what is the energy, please? What do they need to know? I don't do reversals, guys. Yeah, somebody was fucking around being a hoe and fucked around and slipped up and left nine layers to be made in the goddamn ass. So somebody could have got somebody pregnant in the situation. And it could have definitely been a water sign. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Somebody was a hoe. Somebody couldn't be faithful if you paid them. They don't know them. When you say faithful, they're like, huh? What language is that? And this motherfucker was always sneaking out somewhere to go get their own happiness. Never giving a fuck about somebody else's. Nine of Chalices, more Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. Somebody was only concerned about their own wish fulfillment. And the message that I'm getting is somebody liked to spend a lot of time in the park smoking blunts or somewhere close where there was water. It could be quiet where they could smoke and drink to themselves. Why is the Eight of Wands here for my fire signs? Who fucked him over and why? The Devil card came out, so it could have been a Capricorn that they were fucking with that left them, made them feel left out in the cold like they left you out in the cold. The shit was really toxic as fuck. Yeah, we got the Devil card here. We got the Five of Pentacles. So somebody was left out all alone. Somebody could have got kicked out of their shit too. Like, nigga, get your shit. Get your shit and get the fuck out. That's exactly what I'm hearing. So this person might have lost their place to stay. Now they want some shit to come together. They're hoping that things will come together in a situation. Wands energy at the bottom of the deck. I got the Seven of Pentacles, so there could be delays. There could be some blockages. I feel like this person's chakras are totally out of alignment. And there could be some emotional, there could be some mental blockages too. That's Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo energy. So some of y'all could have definitely been dealing with an earth sign. Why is the Four of Chalices here? For my fire signs, who fucked them over and why? What is the messages and what is their energy, please? Got a lot of messages on their Four of Chalices, yo. I'm gonna take every last one because Spirit is telling me to. We have the Ace of Swords. Maybe somebody finally got the truth in the situation. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. Maybe this person was not being truthful or honest with you or themselves. They were self-deceiving and they were deceiving you at the same time. But the truth came out because there was a lot of heartbreak, lies, backstabbing, and betrayal. This motherfucker put your ass to the wheel and spun it and stabbed your ass repeatedly. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. But somebody is being asked to take a leap of faith. Fly, pelican, fly. Tony Montana style. The fool. So you're being asked to fly, soar, move away from this situation. There could be an action of a message being brought in. Somebody could be taking passionate action to move forward and communicate with you or either you, them. Aries, Leo, Sagittarius energy, but somebody is going to need strength in this situation, or you could be dealing with a Leo. We have the Star card here. So some of y'all are still healing from this heartbreak, lies, deception, and betrayal. This is Aquarius energy. So some of you may have Aquarius in your chart, you, them, or both. But this is also conception of a baby. So this could be what you're needing strength for. This might be what some of the things that you found out that caused a lot of heartache and a lot of pain. But victory is here. You have the Six of Wands. So you're going to move forward. Some of you might even take a cruise or a trip. This person may offer you a cruise and a trip because here they are again wanting wish fulfillment. That could be you or them. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio energy, but I feel more like it's them, fire signs. Why is the Four of Wands here for my fire signs? Who fucked them over and why? What is the messages and what is their energy? At the bottom of the deck, we have the Knight of Swords. So there was definitely some harsh communication that came through in the past. It definitely left some folks feeling very guarded, very defensive in a situation. A lot of harsh communication. Yeah, somebody wants to take action like the King of Wands, very passionate, and come forward in this relationship or offer this relationship a commitment. This could be your twin too, is what I'm hearing. But somebody is standing their ground. Somebody is not allowing somebody to come in and try to tell them what the fuck to do or what not to do. Somebody is very defiant at this point. And it could be you're guarding and standing your ground against this person because they want to come in and offer you a cup of love, not a chalices, more water energy. Like I said, it's a lot of water and fire out here. Somebody is manifesting. This could have been somebody else that was outside of the relationship of you and this person doing moon magic to try to keep you motherfuckers from being together, blocking you. Could have been an Aries. King of Pentacles. This person is a take charge person. They take the bull by the horns. This is somebody that is financially stable. This could be somebody that is in the public eye. This person's Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. This is somebody that's financially stable. They could have their own business. This person could be married, don't have to be. Could be in a long-term, stable, committed relationship. All of this shit before I just said looks like a facade, quote unquote, the two fingers on each hand. They could have jits, but they don't have to. Jits as kids. They could be well respected in their society, of peers, their community. People look up to them. People come to them for advice, wise counsel. This person could be very emotionally balanced now and wanting to come in and be available to love. More water energy. And for some of you, this person could have been the water sign that was in a long-term standing committed relationship. I feel like some of this energy, the King of Pentacles, the King of Chalices, is this person's energy. They were loving, stable, and committed in this relationship, but the other person was not who they said they were, just like this person wasn't who they said they were to you. And I feel like this relationship has ran its course. The long-term, stable, committed relationship or marriage that they're in. Why is the Knight of Wands here for my fire signs? Who fucked them over? Why did they fuck them over? What is the messages and what is their energies, please? Yeah, I got too many fucking tens on the board for this shit not to be a wrap. I got the Ten of Swords. I got the Ten of Pentacles. I got the Ten of Cups up here. I got the Ten of fucking Wands down here. Yeah, this is game fucking over. Play the game, you lose. So, they could have been involved with a Aries, Leo, Sagittarius. Oh, shit. Excuse me, y'all. My motherfucking stand. This is my tablet stand because my new stand that I bought, it won't hold my phone. It's like if my phone is too heavy for the stand that encases it and holds it. The stand itself works great, but it's the piece that holds the phone that's giving me the fucking headache. So I had to go back to my, you know, little homemade shit right here working with my tablet stand, but whatever works. But like I said, it could have been a Aries, Leo, Sagittarius that hold around on them and paid their ass back what they gave you. Caused a lot of conflict, a lot of harsh communication. Somebody felt like they really had to defend themselves in the situation. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius. This shit brought on a tower moment. Scorpio, Aries energy. So again, this could have definitely been an Aries that fucked them over in the process of while they fucked you over. And all the while they tried to keep this shit hid, but you were using your intuition. For some of you, at first your intuition was blocked, but then you started calming down and your intuition started kicking in. This is Pisces energy. And you realize that this person was lying to you. They were being dishonest, and very unfaithful in a relationship, not only in your relationship, but in the relationship that they were already in before you. Some of you, I'm being told too, were blindsided by this fucking, this situationship. They put you in a third party situation, and this ain't gonna resonate for every motherfucker in here, fire signs. But some of you already knew that this person was already in a long-term committed relationship or a fucking marriage. You thought they were leaving that marriage to be with you, and they left you high and dry to be with a whole nother motherfucker. And now that shit is backfiring on their asses. They blindsided the fuck out of your ass. And again, this is not going to resonate for everybody, but this person also is into multiple partners. And so is their partner that they were dealing with. This person, whoever they were dealing with, the feminine is bisexual. Nine of Pentacles. So yeah, somebody definitely became single in this situation. Either you or your person is becoming single. You definitely became single in this situation, or you're gonna be, because it was too stressful and it was too fucking burdensome. You want to be fucking happy. You want the Nine of Chalices. You want wish fulfillment. Why did they fuck over my fire signs? What is the messages? What is their energy, please? Somebody retreated from their past life partner, soulmate. They became the Hermit, Virgo energy. So some of y'all could have been dealing with a Virgo. Somebody retreated, either you or them, to get clarity and guidance in a situation. You stuck up and showed up like the Queen of Swords. It's like, I don't even want to hear nothing else from you. I just want you to drink a hot cup and shut the fuck up. Because everything that comes out your motherfucking mouth is a lie. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. Either you stood up like the Queen of Swords, or they're standing up like the Queen of Swords for themselves. But somebody got truth and clarity in a situation not once but twice, and they got the fuck up out of that shit. Now somebody is feeling regretful about this situation. They falling back. They done fall way back. That fallback game is strong. So fire signs, I feel like your fallback game is strong, because y'all don't tolerate being betrayed. You don't like being lied to, because you're very straight up. You're very honest. A lot of people can't handle your level of honesty. You give it to them raw, straight, no chaser, unfiltered. Four of Pentacles. Somebody is heavily focused on their finances, and I'm being told that this motherfucker chose money over love for some of you. And at the bottom of the deck, look at who we got here, the fucking Chariot. So somebody step the fuck off. This is Cancer energy. So some of y'all definitely could have been dealing with a Cancer, because we got an ass of water up here. Ass of water. Some of you could be at a distance from this Cancer. This could be mentally, emotionally, physically, or all the above. Why did they fuck my fire signs over? What is the messages and what is their energy, please? Clarifying the Justice card. Yeah, because the Justice is moving forward, you get a new start. You walk through the fucking door of value. Ace of Pentacles, something stable, something tangible, something grounded. Some of you could be getting a new car. Some of you could, I'm hearing some of y'all got a windfall. Some of y'all hit the motherfucking lottery. When you cut this motherfucker off, shit got better for you, fire signs. Shit got hella better for you. Could have been dealing with a Capricorn towards Virgo. Or you might have this in your chart, you, them, or both, earth and water. But whatever the situation is, you definitely getting a new fucking car out of the deal. You got a new job coming to you for some of you. For others of you, you may have quit an old job to go to a new job. But some of you are definitely going in a whole nother direction with career, finances, the whole thing. You about to level the fuck up, yo. Bossing the fuck up. And look at this. The Sun card. So you're creating your own fucking happiness and your own foundation, fire signs. That's Leo energy. Happiest motherfucking card in the deck. Why did they fuck over my fire signs? And what is the messages and what is their energies, please? Y'all tell me how y'all like this reading in the comments. And I know this is not going to resonate for every fire sign, but I'm just grouping y'all off together. Yes, ma'am, what you want? Oh, I'm fine. You good?
Yes.
Okay, don't forget to close that door when you finish, all right?
Mm-hmm.
Thank you, Mamita. Okay, we got the Five of Swords. So somebody is feeling like there's going to be a lot of conflict if they get back with this person. You're not really fucking feeling it. You're feeling like this person is scared. No. Yeah, they're scared that you're going to get one up on them because they got one up on you. They're scared that you're going to do to them what they did to you. Gemini, Libra, Aquarius energy. And they're fearful of coming back in, but they want to come back in and give you something. They want to come back together with you. They're ready to dump out this Three of Cups situation. They're ready to let go of what no longer serves a purpose in their life. They're dumping out the third party situation, but they're feeling regret, remorse, shame, embarrassment, humiliation, stupidity. But they're so focused on where they fucked up at, they don't see that there's still two cups remaining over here. That's that water sign. Pisces, Cancer, Scorpio. And yeah, look, they want to come in with a tentative offer. Something small, something stable, but it's going to take forever for it to come. Capricorn, Taurus, Virgo. They may have Earth in their chart again. And the Hangman. Somebody has been suspended. Could have been suspended from a job. Somebody could have been suspended from school. This ain't going to resonate for everybody. But maybe somebody's jit got suspended from school. But for others of you, this is for you to take time out and to waken up your crown chakra so you can get a higher perspective of the situation. Pisces energy. Because the World card is here. This cycle has closed. It's time for you to move forward, fire signs, into something new, something, a new start, new beginnings. You got new beginnings coming to you. You already walking through the fucking door of value. Why did they fuck over my fire signs? What is the message? And what is their energies, please? For my fire signs. Okay, the King of Swords. So maybe they're in court right now finding out and determining who is the father of this child that was born or being that's got to be born. Maybe they went in front of the judge for those that have already, the mother has already had the baby, this water sign. They're going through the DNA process right now. King of Swords. And for others of you, you are using your head over your heart about this offer. And if you do accept this offer, be very, very mindful that you could pop up pregnant. So if you are not ready to be pregnant, use protection, please. This was a lesson. We have the Wheel of Fortune here. But the wheel is also spinning in you guys' favor. You learned a very karmic lesson in this situation because this person, both of y'all may have had some karma from the past life to clear up in this lifetime. before you could move forward with this person, for those of you who do. And somebody is definitely drunk in love with your ass, the Ten of Chalices. You make them very happy, fire signs. And they do want wish fulfillment with you. So you definitely, I swear, y'all, I can't say it again. Here's the Ten of Chalices, the Nine of Chalices, and the Sun card. So they definitely want happiness with you, but somebody just didn't know how to be an adult about this shit and come through like a mature person. So I'm going to do some oracle messages on you guys as well. I'm going to start out with the Earth Magic Oracle deck. What is the messages for my fire signs? What is the energies, please? Some of you could be in solitude, but remember, no man is an island. Here is the sun yet again. So a lot of you are going to be shining, 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 yeah. Synergy. And this should be about the summer solstice. So a lot of y'all going to be popping when the summertime comes. Y'all going to be radiating like crazy. Synergy, man. So the sum of two parts come together as a whole to make something greater than the individual parts. And a lot of y'all are going to be celebrating. Y'all going to be getting your jick on. A lot of y'all going to be having a lot of fun dancing, dancing, dancing. And let's do the energy oracle deck for this reading. All of these cards have been blessed, shuffled, and cut, by the way, so we could cut down on the time of the reading. So what is the messages for my fire signs? What is the energies, please? We have the seventh chakra, and I did say that chakras were out of alignment. Some of them might be out of alignment for you, fire signs. So four and one is five. That is conflict, and conflict also brings change. So some of you, and I did say your crown chakra. So not only is, and I believe for some of you, this is your twin. Some of you both need to align your crown chakra. Archangel Uriel is going to assist you with that, or call upon her to give you assistance. And again, you have the sixth chakra, Archangel Metatron. So some of you need to work on your sixth chakra, which is your third eye chakra. And I mentioned this, if y'all go back through your reading, that I mentioned in the Seven of Pentacles, somebody's chakras were way out of alignment. So some of you guys, as well as your person, needs to align some chakras. And we have the healer of the ages. So the Father Divine is with you. Five and one is six. So he's going to help you with the imbalance. That's why he sent you the Archangel Michael to help you get balance in a situation. Because six is balance. Six is imbalance. So he's going to help you get balance in a situation, okay? And at the bottom of this deck, we have the Goddess of the Moon. So some of you definitely could be dealing with your twin. Five and two is seven. Sevens also signify completion, and it also is the spiritual number. 7 days that it took God to create. And this is also Cancer energy. So you are definitely, for some of you, are dealing with a Cancer. Let's pull the Ascended Masters and see what they are talking about. What is the messages for my fire signs? What is the energies, please? at the bottom of the deck, we have mother, wife, sister, daughter, Lady Nada. Lady Nada is asking you to confer with, so it's, this is like talking with your family and friends. But mainly your family. So some of you could be mothers. Some of you could be married. And some of you may have sisters and a daughter where you need to spend some time talking. That's kind of like to me, like let your friends help you. So maybe some of you need to spend some time speaking with the family and see what you can gain out of that. Because sometimes you'd be surprised, even your children have information that you wouldn't think that they have. Point blank, period. Freedom. Ascended Master Hina, or Henna, is saying freedom. So free yourself. Saint Germain is saying work your magic. Like somebody was trying to work some magic on your ass, work your magic, Booski. And don't forget to nurture yourself. Mother Mary insists upon it. When you align your chakras, Matreya, you get the power of joy. And you need to clear and shield your energy, Elmoira. Some of you need to protect your energy shield once you clear it, okay? That's the messages from your ascended masters. Let me see what the romance angels will say before we close out your reading. What is the messages for my fire signs? What is their energy, please? Some of you have new love coming. A new person has stirred your romantic feelings. So don't be guarded. Just use your discernment, I would say. Use your discernment and let your intuition guide you. Some of you could have been dealing with somebody that dealt with addictions. There's a lot of codependency here. Some of you could have had codependency. But you're in a new cycle, so you could have closed out the codependency that caused you to learn the lesson with this person. Addictions are affecting your romantic life. So as you balance and align your chakras, as you continue to do the work upon self, you'll relieve yourself of and release the codependency, any toxicity, any addictions, and you will help raise and increase your vibration. And you'll also give yourself more self-love as you nurture and care for yourself, okay? Now, to close out your reading, we are going to close it out with my favorite deck. And this is the Archangel Oracle deck. What is the messages for my fire signs and what is their energy, please? And these cards are flying every fucking way. Well, shit. Alrighty then. At the bottom of the deck of the Archangel Oracle, we have victory. I did not show y'all victory before. Happiness and victory. Archangel Sandalphon, your prayers have been heard and answered, so have faith. So victory is headed for you. You have victory in this situation, fire signs. You also, Archangel Chamuel is saying, beloved one, I am helping you with your spiritual soulmate relationship. So some of you are being assisted. For those of you who want to continue to work on this relationship with this person, Archangel Chamuel is going to assist you. And for others of you that are moving forward, they're going to help you with that new spiritual soulmate love too. It's up to you, family. Gentleness. Archangel Sandalphon, be very gentle with yourself at this time. Surround yourself with gentle people, situations, and environments. So this could coincide with mother, wife, sister, daughter. This could also definitely coincide with nurture yourself. We have patience. This is the same as Archangel Michael, temperance, the angel of temperance. Archangel Jophiel, your dreams are blooming more rapidly than you realize. Still, they need nurturing and patience. So again, you have two angels that are going to come in and assist you on that. You just need to call on them. One is Jophiel and the other one is Michael, Archangel Michael. Nurture. We just talked about nurture, but this is also another part of this nurturing. Archangel Gabriel, as you nurture a child, you nurture your own child, inner child, and nurture your own inner child. I'm sorry, you guys. Both activities are important for you right now. So I feel like this kind of coincides with Lady Nada. You are safe. Archangel Michael, I am protecting you against lower energies and guarding you, your loved ones, and home. So you are safe. Archangel Michael is assisting you in multiple ways. Divine order, Archangel Raguel, everything is how it needs to be right now. Look past the illusion and see underlying order. So don't be deceived by what you have experienced, what you have been through, fire signs. Move forward. Victory is yours. I hope this message resonated for someone. Please like, comment, subscribe, share with your family and friends. Thank you for allowing me to try out something new. You can find me on Instagram as AscendedTwin144K. I post spiritual messages there, and they also are posted on my Facebook channel, which is Nikita Kelly Ascended Twin. And you'll find me here with full messages, AscendedTwin144K. I love you, soul family. Fire signs, y'all take care of yourself. Peace.